Hey, it's Hirsch, and today I'm going to be reviewing the Adachi 60 set of markers. Adachi kindly sent this set to me to review along with an affiliate link, so make sure to check the description for that. I'll be talking more about that later. And also, even though they did send this to me, all opinions in this video will be 100% my own, and let's get started. So this is the case that the markers come in. It's the 60 set of markers. I quickly reorganized them to fit my color palette more. And one side has a bullet tip and one side has a chisel tip. Now you see me swatching these markers, and I did swatch them in my sketchbook, though Adachi did kindly send a swatching card along with the marker set. It's just that I prefer to swatch them in my sketchbook because the colors will show up more accurately there than on different paper, because markering can look different on different types of paper. I've mentioned this before, but yeah, I just wanted to say it again. Also, my sketchbook and all the other materials that I use in this video are always linked below. I've been getting questions about that recently, so you can just check the description, and most of the time it will be there unless I haven't updated the description yet. This set of markers, I'm using the bullet nib mainly to swatch the markers, and all the there's a very good variety of colors. All of them are very vibrant and saturated, but there's also a good variety of lighter tones, skin tones, mid tones, and dark tones. And the only thing that I would suggest that they do is maybe could include more pastel neutral tones. They also did include quite a lot of grays, which I like in a set, and they also had some skin tones. I also would recommend them to include some darker skin tones, because I know that a lot of people like using dark skin tones in comparison to light skin tones. But yeah. So they do have the marker name on the cap, which I think is very, very nice. And they also have the number, but I usually reference the number because most marker sets just have the numbers. And here's the finished marker swatching sheet. As you can see, I wrote Adachi markers in a little like calligraphy below the swatches. So yeah. Now we get on to the blending test. So in this test, I am using a purple, a blue, and a gray, light gray sort of color. So first thing that I'm doing is laying down the gray because it's the lightest shade, and then I'm going ahead and using the purple, and I'm using that to kind of go as like the middle tone to blend in the gray to the blue. I really like how well these Adachi markers blended, especially considering that they don't have a brush tip on them. And basically, having a brush tip just makes it easier to blend, but chisel tips can also blend really well, and I just prefer using brush tips because that's what I'm used to. But these actually worked really, really well, and I had a lot of fun using them. They also gave a super clean and smooth blend, despite how different the purple and the gray are with each other. Now we get on to the kind of trial practice drawing. I decided to do one of them because it's been a while since I have used non-brush tip markers, so I did kind of want to see how that would affect my coloring style. Honestly, it didn't do that much, and this was mainly just for me to get the hang of coloring in general, because I have been trying to experiment more with the way that I color. So basically, I just drew this little girl. She has like a little sprout coming out of her head, which I think is kind of cute. And she does have black hair. The drawing that I do later on, which you will see in a couple of minutes, also has a darker hair, so this definitely helped me to figure out the style that I wanted to color in. And I also really, really like how there's like a really big variety of shades in this marker. There's one color from all of the colors of the rainbow, plus more, and there's also different shades of that color as well, which I really, really like. So this is how the drawing is coming out. As you can see, I added some highlights with my gel pen. I also really, really like how her clothes came out. It's like this cozy purple turtleneck. And yeah. So here's how that came out. Now I am adding a blue background, and that is pretty much it for the practice piece. And let's move on to the actual piece. So in today's video, I'm going to be coloring this drawing that I did of Raiden Shogun. Raiden is a character from Genshin Impact who I've been really wanting to have a rerun for. I'm not going to get too much into Genshin Impact in this video though. It's going to be mainly focused on the markers. But if you would like to see a draw and chat with me about other topics, then make sure to comment that down below, because I'm always looking for like more video ideas and stuff like that. And yeah. So Raiden Shogun, she does have a light skin tone, and like I said before, this set could come with a little more darker skin tones or like tans, so I did go with a lighter skin tone for her. As you can see, the ink does change a lot after it's laid down in my sketchbook. I found that if you use lighter colors like this peach that I'm using, it actually becomes a little bit more saturated in the end, and this isn't like because of filters or anything, it's just purely how the markers are. But I have to say, I really enjoyed using it like this. I feel like I've gotten too comfortable with just using pastel shades or neutral shades, so it's really nice to step out of your comfort zone for once in a while. And I have to say, I had so much fun using these markers. Like, usually when I'm using brush tip markers, I usually try and be more precise with what I do, and I try to pay more attention, and I try to make it look very clean and detailed. For this, when I used the chisel tip and the bullet nib, I actually tried being more free with my movements, and I think that definitely helped a lot. So now is kind of when I'm getting into the ugly phase. I'm not sure whether or not I want to continue the drawing, but we all go through that in our art, so make sure to continue the drawing that you're doing. So after that, I realized that instead of just using the purple to shade, so what I like to do usually when I'm shading is I use the purple to shade the skin, and the set did come with a light purple, but it didn't work that well with the skin tone because the skin tone was more on the yellow side, or like the orangey side, instead of the rosier tone that I usually go for, which is fine obviously, but I just had to add a pink layer over the purple, and then I had to add purple again, so it gave like a really nice effect. Honestly, I really like how like depth it gives to the shadows. And yeah, now we move on to drawing the hair. As you can see, I did start off by doing some pink highlights, and I think I did keep some of them in the end, but most of them I didn't really like how it looked, so I just like went over all of them with this kind of light purple color that I'm using right now. It's also the same purple that I use for the skin, in case you're wondering. That's why I'm kind of alternating between the skin and the hair. One thing that I did learn with these markers is that it's definitely best to layer them slowly. It's not something that you really want to rush with these markers, and I know that some people, they just want to get their art done fast, and it's not like a bad thing, but I would definitely say that taking your time definitely makes these markers shine more, and that's more of their strength. They also didn't have much of a shade to go from the really dark purple to the really light purple. And so I kind of had to move around that a little bit. So I did use this technique where like I pressed the two markers against each other, the light purple and the dark purple. And it's kind of this trick that I feel like a lot of people do when they're kids with Crayola markers. But then basically the ink color bleeds onto the other one. And then for like a short amount of time, the other marker will cut out ink that's in the color of the other marker, and it'll create this nice blend if you use it correctly. I'm not sure if any of that makes sense, but that's kind of the technique that I used to color the hair. Again, I really like how the dark purple looks with Raiden's hair. I think it's like a really deep, saturated purple, but it matches this drawing really well. And so I really like how the hair came out. So yeah, I'm just going in with a dark purple, and I layer that over a kind of cool gray color to get the darker parts of her outfit. And then I colored in the bow using a little bit of red. Also, comment down below if you guys like these chattier videos where I talk throughout the entire video, or if you prefer me just talking in like small segments and more of the music shining through, because I want to know your preference. Or should I make like a mix of both videos, or should I put them out like differently? Like one video has more music and one video has more talking, like alternating every week. Also, adding the final touches to my Raiden Shogun piece. I hope you guys enjoyed watching this video. I definitely had a great time using these markers. By the way, there is a link below in the description, which is an affiliate link, meaning that if you purchase something from that link, then I will get a small commission at no extra cost to you, obviously. So thank you guys so much for watching this video. I hope you guys enjoyed how this looks, how this drawing came out. Also, the lighting looks so pretty. Like, I don't know. I just really like the lighting in this part of the video, like the sunlight coming through. Yes. Okay, so thank you guys so much for watching today's video. I hope you guys enjoyed. And thank you to Adachi for sending me their markers to review. I had a great time using them. And make sure to check the link below in the description again. Stay safe, stay healthy, and peace out.